What's good, guys? Welcome back to the Montevallo High School podcast. My name is Tyler Gentry, and I'm here with
Javon Rogers.
All right, today we're going to be on the topic of discussion of, you know, competition and, you know, what competition is and, you know, the pros and cons of competition. Yep. So, Javon, you want to get it started for us?
Yeah, that's fine. It's fine. Yeah. So, the definition of competition is the activity or condition of competing. And basically, you know, everybody competes. Everybody, you know, has a source, of competitive nature. And competitiveness can be good or bad, you know, in certain situations, though.
Feel me? All right, give me an example of one where competitive is bad, is a bad thing.
Okay. I'd probably say, say you're probably on the come up in whatever you do, either a job, sports, basically comparing yourself and trying to compete with others that, you know, aren't paying you any mind, and you're only worried about what they have going on and their success, when you're not focusing on yourself and trying to be the best person that you could be.
All right. I want to say, in my opinion, I don't think, you know, competition. Well, let me put it like this. I feel like you're always going to be at your best when you're in competition. Mm-hmm. You're always going to be in competition with somebody. But when you focus on that competition being with you and yourself, and just being the best that you can be, that's when you're going to really see it. That's when you'll really see yourself, you know. That's excelling. When you're really going to see the most improvement, yeah. You know.
Yeah.
I feel like a lot of people get so caught up in winning and, you know, want to be a winner, whatever. They really,
yeah,
it takes over and it, you know, they lose the real meaning of.
Yeah, why they doing it, yeah. I don't think competition bad. I think it's good because it strives everybody to be, you know, the best they can be. And obviously, each other. Compete with each other. And at the end of the day, it make everybody better, especially when you're doing it in a positive way.
Yeah, I feel like, for example, if you're in a track meet, you know, you run track, so you'll know this.
Yeah.
Or, you know, even if you're just racing with friends,
mm-hmm.
you gonna push yourself to way past mm-hmm. you ever thought you can run.
Yeah.
You know, because you wanna keep up with that person in front of you. You wanna beat that person in front of you.
Yeah.
So you're gonna give it your all, you know, to get in front of them, and you wanna win the race. But with every winner, there's a loser.
Yeah, I feel you.
So, I mean, there could be one person that's in that race, you know, been training, you know, working consistently, you know, and you get in that race and then you lose, and it's just somebody that you just lose because it's, I mean, the person you lost to is just better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, you know, when something like that happens, it can be real demotivating for somebody. You know, you put in all this work and you're not seeing it paying off. And, you know, it kind of be like, why am I even doing this?
Yeah. Because
I did this for this reason. And then I come here and, you know, I'm just not really seeing it.
Yeah, I feel you. I feel like competitiveness, it creates more productivity and better quality, you know, of service, like people, and better quality in people. As far as, like, companies and, like, sports and like all that type of thing, especially in companies, because, you know, companies compete with each other all the time. Nike, Adidas, Under Armour, yeah, competing brands like stores and stuff like that. I believe it helps, but it's definitely discouraging when something else getting love in your particular, you know, area isn't. But that's just how it be sometimes.
Yeah, a lot of it is also a mind thing. You know, when you get into any kind of sport, you know, anything with competing with somebody, you got to be not only physically strong, but you got to be mentally strong.
Mm-hmm.
You got to know that, you know, every day isn't going to be a W. Yeah. You know, you're going to have these setbacks. You're going to take L's. You're going to lose. Everybody has to fail before you succeed.
Yeah.
And that when you fail before you succeed, you appreciate your success even more. Somebody that just rolls through everything, you know, perfect life, never have any struggles, any failures, or anything. It's always gonna be harder for them because they don't know how to accept failure.
Yeah,
I feel like learning to accept failure from the beginning is, you know, a great way for you to move forward. Because if you move forward without any failure, you start to get complacent.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like a lot of people when they fail early, and then they get that success, they continue to succeed because they know that feeling of failure, and they don't want to go back to that. That's why a lot of NBA players, a lot of, you know, NFL players, they get out of high school, they say, I'm gonna continue to work. You know, even with rappers, whatever, they say, I have all this money, but people try to tell them, oh, you made all this money, why are you still working?
Mm-hmm.
I know for a fact, Soulja Boy, he said in the interview that I don't care if I go in there and make $30 million today, I'm gonna go back tomorrow and I'm gonna make another $30 million. He said he know what it feels like to not have nothing and come from nothing.
Yeah.
So he don't want to ever feel that ever again. So that would, you know, continues to push him and, you know, be that best version of him that he can possibly be. And yeah, I feel like that's a good mindset to have. You know.
Yeah. I feel like with competition, probably a disadvantage, you'll have to be prepared for disappointment, because somebody might have something that you want to get that you're striving for and they already have it and they're levels above you. But you can't participate in unhealthy competition. That leads to just lowering yourself down and lower engagement, and it's stressful too. So just try to stay positive if you feel me, partake in positive competition. I just think it's different types of competition, positive and negative competition.
So, I completely agree with that.
Yeah.
Well, guys, that's all the time we had today. I appreciate y'all for stopping by the Monty Valley High School podcast. You know, we are now currently posting these on YouTube, so if you don't mind, drop a like on the podcast if you enjoyed. And if you want to stay tuned for further podcast videos, etc., you know, be sure to you know, click that subscribe button. And if you want to be notified when we drop anything, whether it's, you know, video, broadcast, podcast, whatever it is, whatever the case may be, click that notification bell, click all, and you'll get every notification when we drop. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I'll see y'all in the next one.
Peace.